we're making butter sticks. And those are just crackers that are butter flavored, so you can use them for anything that you might use a butter cracker for. I'm going to use them with a salad that I made recently, a hearts of palm salad. And I think that's going to be the perfect complement to the salad. But it's not just for salads. If you have a nice dip, something like an herb flavored dip, we've done some things like dill wheat dip. We've done a saucy dip that had French dressing in it. Something that's kind of delicate like that will be good with this cracker. Now, I wouldn't use it on a Mexican dip because those are better with fritos and tortilla chips and things like that. So just make your own judgment as to how you want to use this recipe. But basically, it's for anything that you would use a butter cracker with. So let's start with this baking mix. Now, a lot of you use Bisquick, and I normally do too. This just happens to be a different brand, but it's the same as Bisquick. So if you would prefer or feel more comfortable with Bisquick, that's fine, but you need something that says buttermilk, biscuit, and baking mix. And on the back, there are all these recipes. Now, this one's not on the back. This is one that was made up. So when you open the top, you're able to pour. What we're going to need is 2 cups of this. So 2 cups of baking mix of your choice, Bisquick or some other type. And then we're going to pour into that some cold water. So I want you to see, this is cold because I have ice cubes in it. And I quite often do that when I'm working with pie crusts or anything that has to be rolled out. And I'm going to use 1/2 cup of that in just a second. Before I do that, because I don't want it to warm up, I want to tell you about the preparation over here. This is a 13x9x2 inch Pyrex dish, and it has butter melted in it, as you can see. What you start with is 1/3 cup of butter. You can use salted or unsalted, and you melt that butter, and it doesn't matter how you do it. I use the microwave, or you can put it in this and put it in the oven because we're going to be using the oven, but somehow get into your dish 1/3 cup of melted butter, and then well, go ahead and pour this 1/2 cup of very cold water. And for me, that means ice water. 1/2 cup all the way to the top of this measure. And then, oops, excuse me. Then pour that in. And then use a fork to mix that around. And what I want to do is bring this into a ball. And you can see that it will come into a ball, but it's going to take me a minute. So I'm going to go away, get this into a ball, and then when I come back, I will be over here at the right side of my counter. Once you get your dough into a ball like this, then you bring it over to a floured surface, and I just took some flour, plain flour or self-rising, it doesn't really matter, but you just sprinkle some on a surface that you plan to use, and I always use my countertop, and I'm just really careful with it that I don't damage it, but you need to knead this about 5 times, so you just press it and then turn and press it in another direction and keep turning and pressing. And I've been working on it just a little bit, so it should be ready to go. But that helps in the process of rolling it out and getting it in the form that we want. So remember that step of kneading it about 5 times. And then kind of get it flattened out a bit. And our goal is to put it down on this floured surface, which I need to distribute this flour a little bit, and roll it into a rectangle. So I have my rolling pin out and ready, and I guess this is good enough to start with. So I'm going to put it down and then sprinkle a little bit on the top so that my rolling pin will not stick to the top. And then I'm going to get started, and then I'll go away and get this into a nice rectangle and come back and show it to you. I have my dough rolled out, and you can see that it's not symmetrical. Don't expect it to be. It's kind of hard to roll. It's kind of tough dough. But what you're going to do at this point is cut it into little strips that will be your butter sticks. And the way I've decided to do it is come down the center. Now this is a knife that is, they call it a steak knife, but it's really not very sharp. But what I'm doing is making this division, not cutting the counter. I'm just dividing so that I'll be able to pick up the pieces of my butter sticks. This will make it a little easier if I just go to each edge and clean it off a little bit. So you see, I'll be coming down this edge, just squaring it up. And some places won't be quite even. That doesn't really matter. But I think I have enough removed that I can show you the cutting of one of these. Now you want them about 3/4 of an inch wide. And this might be about 4 inches, 3 to 4, 3.5 inches. I can't really tell, but maybe 3/4 of an inch wide. And we'll just cut that. And what I'm going to do is lift it up, take it over to my pan that is buttered, and I'm going to dip it in and get both sides buttered and then just lay it aside. We'll come back and arrange those later. So let me get my work done. I get all of these cut out and arranged, and then I'll show it to you before I put it in the oven. So this is how your butter sticks will look before they go into the oven. If you want them salted, or if you want to put some pepper or seasoned pepper on them, this would be the time to do it. Or if you wanted to put some kind of herbs on it, do it before it's baked. So I didn't plan to do any of that. These are just butter sticks, and they're going in a 425 degree oven, and they should bake maybe 12 minutes or so. I'm going to start watching them at about 10 minutes, and they might be done then. They might take as long as 15, so I'll let you know how long I bake them. Here are my finished butter sticks, and you can see what they look like. It took about 10 minutes, maybe 10 and a half. I left them in the oven at 425. And when you bring them up, you need a plate to put them on, and you can just arrange them however you like. You can see I had them arranged like this because that's the way they would fit in. And I ended up getting, 22. There was some dough left over, so if I'd used a larger pan, I could have gotten a few more, or I can rework what I have and use this pan again with some more butter in it. Use your own judgment on that. It also depends on how thick these are. These are puffed up a little bit from the 1/4 inch that they started out, but they look very nice. So let me continue to get these off of the pan onto the plate, and then we'll serve them. Here's my complete recipe of butter sticks. And I think you'll find it a kind of a neat and a little bit fancy way of serving something, because it's just not opening a box of crackers. That doesn't impress anybody. But when you go to the trouble of making them, it's not that much trouble, but it shows that you care a little bit more than just to open a box. So to serve this, I would just take a few of these, and notice the backside. It's not burned at all. It's just nice and crusty and brown, a little browner than the top side. But just take a few of these, and you notice they turn up a little bit. If you let them do that at the edges of the pan, if you don't want that, then make sure they don't touch the edge, and just keep them straight and flat. So just take a few of these and put them over with your salad, however you like to arrange them. And doesn't that look nice and appealing? I'm going to show you the texture. These are so hot, I shouldn't do this, but they're a little crispy and crunchy, but they're a little more on the biscuit side. But they taste very good.